What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's Michael, and I hope y'all are having a great day. Today we got something a little bit different going on. You know, we've been doing a couple videos with vlogs, you know, the Jeep review, which has been doing incredibly well. First video has been doing really, really well as well. You guys have been killing it. It's up to about 260 views over the past few days, which is absolutely insane. So I can't thank y'all enough for that. Second video, like I said, is doing super, super well. Almost to 100 views on that one. And the feedback's been really, really good with that as well. So today, you're probably wondering, Michael, why are we on Reddit? Why are we on something called Car Mods furthermore? Well, today we are going to do a little filler video. Just something to, you know, fill the time between the videos I'm working on. I don't know if I mentioned it in the previous video, but I do have a collab coming up with a buddy, which will be coming out either at some point this weekend or later next week. And that brings me up to my second reason. This video today is going to be, like I said, more of a filler video, just something that's a little funny, a little goofy, and maybe get a little more of a response from y'all as to what type of series you guys want to see between the big videos that take me a long time to edit. We are going to be doing our own little spin on it. Instead of Car Mods Day, we are doing Truck Mods. And if you guys like it enough, might make it a whole series. So let's go ahead and get straight into it and see what we got first on this Reddit. Face down, that's the way we like to truck, seen in San Antonio. Alright guys, I can already tell this is going to be pretty bad. Alrighty, so as you guys saw, I don't know what this guy's trying to do. If he's trying to be like a funny car, like one of those drag cars, or what he's trying to do, but he's got skinnies up front, some big old mud tires in the rear, and it looks like he's hauling a ladder. Buddy, I don't think that bumper guard is going to do you much good when you're just plowing through looking like a drag car. Yeah, definitely not something that I would drive. And to make it even worse, it's like a work truck. It's not even like a Platinum or anything. It's just, you know, your bone stock base trim Ford F-150 from about 2004 to 2008, that model year. So I don't know what he was thinking. I don't know what he was doing with that. You know, if he couldn't afford the front tires, you know, I get that. We're all a little strapped for cash sometimes. But honestly, just wait. Just wait until you can afford the tires and don't look like you're just a goofball at this point. It's also kind of a safety hazard too, right there. Imagine if those ladders just went straight through the rear glass. It's a pretty grim thought, but anyways, moving to the next one. Lifted VW Beetle plow truck. So honestly, I'm going to be real with you guys. This isn't too bad. I personally would never drive it, but at least he was creative about it. I mean, how many times do you see a lifted Beetle? Especially one that has the back chopped off too. Like, look at that, like right back here. He's got the back chopped off. I wish there was more pictures, but he's got the back chopped off. He doesn't have any mirrors. He's got some skinnies, but I mean, they're pretty big for a Beetle. He's got a little snowplow on it. You know, the thing's probably gonna topple over as soon as he tries to go through a pile of snow, but in all honesty, yeah. It's a weird looking car. I'm not gonna call it a truck because it's not a truck. Give it to him, he was being unique about it, that's for sure. Found this gem while searching for a truck to buy, couldn't resist checking it out. So you guys, I mean, if you've seen Initial D or seen any of the drifting like animes or videos or anything, you're probably wondering, hey, is that an AE86, you know? Is that Trueno? I probably butchered that name, you know, because I don't really tune into it, but you know what I'm talking about, the car I'm talking about, right? That Toyota, the little hatchback? No, guys, you guys are completely off of that one. This thing is obviously just built and ready to go off-road. I mean, those things have to be at least, you know, 30-inch tires. That has to be, you know, a custom paint job. Look at the frame. He probably swapped the entire, you know, chassis of the vehicle and just put the body on there. Probably did some crazy stuff. He's even got the Cybertruck look going on right there. I mean, how can you deny that this thing is just an, you know, not an off-road beast? And it's for sale too. Maybe this is the truck he was buying, you know? He's just trying to flex on all of us. But in all honesty, oh, he's even got the price. It was a Cybertruck. 2020 Cybertruck, $25,000, driven 350 miles. In all honesty, guys, you know, the deposit wasn't that big. It was $1, and the truck's starting at about 30 grand. So which would you rather have, an actual Cybertruck or somebody hitting a midlife crisis? I don't know. It's up to y'all. And just scrolling through here, guys, I'm just seeing an overwhelming amount of Cybertruck ripoffs already. And yet another one. Look, that guy, he took a Taco, a perfectly good Tacoma. Modest-looking truck, you know, just single cab, gray. It's pretty clean. I mean, like, There's no, it might just be the low lighting, but there's no visible rust or paint chipping. And he decided to chuck that on. Like, you're not fooling anybody. The rest of the car, number one, is just completely curvy. And then number two, you got this angular piece right here, not even painted. I don't know what he was thinking, guys. Look at this. Chevy must have just announced this. Introducing the Chevrolet Camaro pickup truck Corvette. You guys were hyped for the C8 and the mid-engine. Psh, who needs that when you can get this? Look at that. Double-decker wing. No, excuse me. Triple-decker if you can count the one up on the roof right here. So you got triple wings on this thing right here. Look at that custom paint job. It's like primer. Like a grayish pink primer. Look at that. He's got spare wheels all the way around, or they're just missing their hubcaps. I don't know what's going on with that. It's sad to say that this internet box eventually burned down, F in the chat. Even with all its intakes. guys, but in all honesty, you know, this guy, he had to know this was a joke. There's no way he drove this around thinking that he was flexing on anybody or being cool or anything like that. This had to be a joke, or at least I pray that it was, because I would hate to be the person driving this. So guys, let me tell you a little bit of a story. This car did not start this way, obviously. It occurred when a German and a redneck decided to get together, and they were deciding on what car to buy. You know, the German, of course, they wanted a BMW, but then the redneck wanted a truck, so what was the result? Well, they gave the car down to their high school son, and this is what he tried to make out of it, you know? If you can't have one or the other, you might as well have the best of both worlds. So, yeah. But in all honesty, guys, this thing is just, it's terrible. It looks like something you would see out of, like, Rocket League or something. Like, it's got the camo wrap, which is cool. I mean, if it were just a BMW or just a truck without camo wrap, that'd be pretty cool. Like they said down here, poor taste, great execution. Yeah, I mean, for what it is, it looks insane, but it's just not all there. This dude caught me taking a picture of his race truck. Yeah, I mean, I would say, you know, that's definitely a race truck, you know. Look, he's got the numbers on it. He's got the Chevy logo. He's got the Chevy logo right here. He's got a splitter up top. He's got the roll bars in the rear. You know, those tires, perfect size right there. They're blacked out with the yellow center caps. He's even got the hood scoop, racing stripes, the auxiliary lights and everything. This guy, he knows what's going on, you know? He's gonna pull up to, you know, a supercar or, you know, he could probably whoop a Prius's ass with that thing. I don't get why people do this to their cars or to their trucks. Even right now, I'm feeling secondhand embarrassment for this guy just, like, looking at this post. Alrighty, guys, we have reached the end of today's video. If you guys did enjoy, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and give me some feedback down below if you guys have any recommendations for a series, and so on and so forth, or just, like, reviews and content you want to see, let me know. Remember, be authentic, and I'll see you guys next time.